Hi students, welcome back to our new course on CNC machines. And in this course, we will learn about CNC turning programming and CNC milling programming. So I'm going to upload a couple of lectures in this particular module. So kindly watch all the video lectures so that you will get the knowledge about the CNC programming in detail. So now let us start our first lecture in this module, that is the introduction about the CNC machines. In today's lecture, we will learn about introduction and definition of CNC machines, advantages and disadvantages, and then the evolution of the NC machine from the beginning to till now, and then types of numerical control, that is, what is NC, what is CNC, and DNC. And then in the end, we will learn about the CNC control panel, and what are the different keys that are there in our control panel, and how to use those keys, and how to move the axis of the CNC machine tool, that we will learn in this particular lecture. What is CNC? CNC stands for computer numerical control. And if we have to define it, then we can say CNC is the automatic control of machine tools by a computer and computer program. In other words, we can say a computer rather than a person will directly control the machine tool here. And as we know that before CNC, the motions of the machine tool had to be controlled manually or mechanically, such as with the help of cams or tracer system. Now, let me explain you this in a very detailed way. Now, as we know that machine tools are around us since the industrial revolutions, and you are familiar with some of the conventional machine tools that you might have seen in workshops, such as lathe machine, drilling machine, milling machines, or drill presses, etc. And as we know that these machines are operated by a skilled machinist who carefully turns the hand wheels in order to move the levers to position the workpiece or cutting tool in the proper orientation. And this type of machining is known as manual machining. And manual machining requires a great deal of operator's skill and training to produce high quality of parts on a consistent basis. And manual machining is also relatively slow and expensive. But now, today, the manual machine tools have been largely replaced by computer numerical control machine tools, or we can say CNC machine tools. The machines still perform essentially the same functions, but here now the movements of the machine tool are controlled electronically rather than by hands. Now CNC machine tools can work or can produce the same part over and over again with very little variations. They can run day and night, week after week without getting tired. So these are obviously some of the advantages of the CNC machines over the manual machines, which we will also cover in today's class in the coming slides. But I would like to mention one point over here. Kindly note this thing. This does not mean that the manual machine tools are obsolete or we are not using them. No. They are still in use extensively for tool and fixture work, for maintenance and repair work, and for small volume productions. However, much of the high and medium volume production work is now performed on CNC machine tools. Furthermore, CNC machining has become common in the low volume job shops, where the lot sizes of a dozen to several hundred of parts are common. And how to make the decision whether we go for the conventional machines or for the CNC machines. This decision is mainly driven by setup cost and volume. As we know that the setup cost to perform a machining operation on a conventional machine tool is rather low as we are going for a CNC machine tool, which is very high. But in summation, as the production volume increases, the combination of productivity gains and the ability to spread the setup cost over many parts makes CNC machining is the obvious choice. So the next part is basically how CNC machine works. The axial movements of the CNC machine tools are guided by a computer, which reads the programs and instructs the several motors to move in the appropriate manner. The motor in turn causes the table to move and produce the machined part. Of course, the computer does not know what shape you want to cut until you write a program to describe the part. The conceptual idea of controlling a machine tool electronically is rather simple. Now, let me explain you this with the help of a figure. Let us say this is our CNC machine tool. This is our driving system. This is our cutting tool. This is our workpiece. This is our table. And this is our bed. Now, once the manufacturing operator or the CNC programmer writes the programs in the form of numerical data, which is simply called as NC code or CNC code also. And then he inserts that NC code in the MCU of the CNC machine. MCU stands for machine control unit, or simply called as controller. And after that, the computer reads the instructions and sends the electrical signals in the form of pulses to the motors like this, which then turns a screw to move the machining table. Now the sensors which are mounted on the table or on the motor sends the positioning information back to the computer. Now once the computer determines that the correct location has been reached, the next move will be executed. And this cycle repeats itself over and over again until the end of the instructions is reached. So this is a simplistic but very accurate view of a typical CNC machine tools. And after that, finally, we will get our processed part. So I hope it will be now very clear to you that how CNC machines works. So now next we have the advantages of the CNC machines. The process is more specific than manual machining. It helps in producing many complex three-dimensional shapes, which are not possible with the conventional machine tools. Then next we have flexibility in job change and automatic tool change settings, because the tool will change automatically. There is no need to change the tool with the help of hands, and less scrap is there. Then we have CNC machines will be used in that particular area where we need a high level of repetitive tasks. And lastly, we have that in machine tools, the program is stored in the memory of the computer. When we insert the program in the MCU or the controller of the CNC machine tools, that program is stored in the memory of the computer. And we can use that program again and again. There is no need to write the same program again for the same job. So this is the advantage of the CNC machine tools. And last, we have the CNC machine offers greater additional flexibility and computational capabilities. Now let us look into the disadvantages of the CNC machine tools. First is that the setup is costly and we need skilled operator to work on CNC machines. Then next we have computers and programming knowledge is required, whomsoever is working on the CNC machine tools. Then last we have the maintenance of the CNC machine tool is difficult. So these are some of the disadvantages of the CNC machine tools. Now, let us look into the evolution of the NC machine tools, how NC evolved since beginning to till now. So let us look into this particular evolution. The first CNC machine was built in 1951 at MIT, USA for manufacturing of the aircraft components that are having intricate profiles using electron tubes and core memories. Let me just explain you this evolution in a very detailed way. It was in 1947 when numerical control was born. It began when John C. Parsons of the Parsons Corporation, Traverse City, Michigan, a manufacturer of helicopter rotor blades, could not make his templates fast enough. So he invented a way of coupling the computer equipment with a jig borer. And Mr. Parsons used punched cards to operate his digitron system. And in 1949, it was the year of urgent need when U.S. Air Material Command realized that parts of its planes and missiles were becoming more complex. Also, as the designs were constantly being improved, changes in the drawings were frequently made. Thus, in their search for methods of fast production, an Air Force facility contract was awarded to Parsons Corporation at that time. The Servo Mechanisms Laboratory of the MIT Massachusetts Institute of Technology was the subcontractor at that time. But later on, in 1951, MIT took the complete job, and in 1952, the prototype of today's NC machine was successfully demonstrated. And remember this thing, the term NC, that is numerical control, it was originated at MIT first. So this was the evolution of NC machine systems. And after that, the technology advancement from the tube technology to the open architecture system has enabled to revolutionize the manufacturing processes. Now, next, let us look into the types of numerical control. Now, there are three types of numerical control. First is the conventional numerical control, which is simply called as NC. Second, we have computer numerical control, which is called as CNC. And third, we have direct numerical control or DNC. Or direct numerical control, we can also call it as a distributed numerical control. Okay. Distributed numerical control. Now let us understand about conventional numerical control, which is simply called as NC. So here data is sent to the machine tool by means of punch cards or tapes. The reader at the machine tool performs no calculations or interpolations. Now this figure shows the three basic components of a numerical control system. Figure A shows a program of instructions. Figure B shows the controller unit. And figure C shows the machine tool. Now let me explain you all these basic functions of a numerical control in a detailed way. So first is the program of instructions. And program of instructions is the detailed step-by-step set of directions which tell the machine tool what to do. And it is coded in the form of numerical or symbolic form on some type of input medium that can be interpreted by the controller unit or by MCU. The second basic component of the NC machine is the controller unit. This is the controller unit. It consists of electronics and hardware that read and interpret the program of instructions and convert it into mechanical actions of the machine tools. Now, the third basic component of our NC system is the machine tool. It is the part of the NC system which performs useful work. This machine tool consists of work table and spindle. And it also includes the cutting tools, work fixtures, and other auxiliary equipments that are needed in machining operations. So here in NC system, that is in numerical control, this first part, that is the program of instructions, that program of instructions at that time written on the tape or punched tape, you can say. And the second figure, which is a controller, the controller in NC system is called as your reader, tape reader, which reads the tape. And the third is the machine tool. So kindly remember all these three basic components because they are most important in NC system. Next, this figure shows the NC system with machine tool and the controller. This is the machine tool and this is the controller. And this figure 3 shows the NC machining center because it consists of number of cutting tools over here with the computer control. So both the pictures are of numerical control machines. Next, let us see what is computer numerical control, which is simply called as CNC. So the idea of computer numerical control is to position a computer right at the machine tool. And all the machine tools which are numerically controlled are called as CNC machine tools. So this figure shows a CNC machine tool. Here you can see this is the controller, this is the spindle, this is the tailstock, and the whole body of the CNC machine. Now, if we have to understand the CNC machine tools in a very simple way, then we can say if a one computer is controlling the one machine tool, that is called as your CNC machine. We can say this is your computer, one computer is placed over here, and it is controlling the one machine tool or one machine only. Then this is called as your CNC machines. Next, we have direct numerical control, which is called as DNC or distributed numerical control. So it is a method where a single computer controls many numerical control machine tools. And these machine tools may or may not be of a similar nature. So the difference between CNC and DNC, now you can understand that in CNC, the one computer was controlling the one machine tool. But here in DNC, now the one computer is controlling many machine tools, which may or may not be of similar nature. So here in this figure shows the DNC system. And this is the computer. And this computer now here is called as central mainframe computer. And this central mainframe computer is now controlling all the machine tools. Let us say this is machine tool one. This is machine tool two. Machine tool three. Machine tool four and machine tool five. So we can control number of machine tools with the help of one central mainframe computer here in DNC system. Now kindly note one thing over here, whether we talk about NC, CNC and DNC, all these three categories are numerically controlled because NC is already there. Now there is a big difference over here between NC, CNC and DNC. Let me just highlight that for you. NC, and then we have second category, which is CNC and DNC. As we know, the first basic component for NC was program of instruction. And program of instruction in case of NC was written on tape or punched tape. But here in CNC and DNC for both, this is called as a computer program, which will be written in any type of input medium. Computer program. Now, if you want to change our program, then we can easily change that program in CNC and DNC because it is in the form of soft copy. But on the other hand, if you want to change your NC code, that is the program of instruction, which is written on the tape or the punched tape, it is very difficult to change because we have to take every time a new tape and then we have to punch the program on the tape. Then finally, we have to insert that into the controller of the machine tool. So that was difficult if you want to edit the program in case of NC. But in CNC, we can easily change our program. Second component is, as we know, it is a controller or MCU. So in case of NC, it was a tape reader. It was a tape reader. But here, in case of NC or CNC, it is simply a computer. And third component, that is the machine tool, which will remain same for all NC, CNC, and DNC, machine tool. So this is the basic difference between NC, CNC, and DNC. So kindly note this thing over here. This figure shows the control panel of MCU, and MCU stands for machine control unit or simply a controller. This is our MCU, which is also known as controller. Now controller, as we know, it is the second basic component of our NC system. It consists of hardware and software. It reads the programs and interprets their program, and then it sends the electrical signals to the motors in the form of pulses. Now, there are different types of controllers that are available in the market, which are made by different companies. Now, let me highlight some of them to you. We have Panu controller, which is the very most popular controller. We have Siemens controller. We have GSK controller, MAC3. We have HMT controller. We have Mitsubishi controller and so on. You will find lots of controllers. Now, let me just explain this information to you, that what is the different information that is available here in this MCU. This is the display screen of our MCU or the monitor screen. So this is a display screen. And in our display screen, X and Z are the axes and the exact location of the X and Z right now. These are the machining parameters which are shown here. And this is the program which is written here. And program is simply called as CNC program or NC code. And this is the keyboard of our MCU. And on our keyboard, there are a number of keys that are available here. Let me explain them to you. These are the alpha keys or alpha characters like G, X, M, Y, and so on. And these are the numerical keys or number keys from 0 to 9. Now, apart from that, There are a number of keys also available here, like DEL, EOB, CN. Let me explain them to you one by one. The first is DEL. DEL stands for delete key. If you want to delete anything in our program, then we can use this delete key. Next, we have EOB. EOB stands for end of block. End of block means if, suppose we are writing a program and we want to enter into the new line of the program, then we can press this EOB button and we can go to the next line. So this EOB acts like an enter button, which you might have seen in our normal computer keyboard. So EOB stands for end of block. Next, we have CAN. CAN stands for cancel. So this is our cancel button. Next, we have MPG. MPG stands for manual pulse generator. And this is the MPG button here. In order to move the axis of the CNC machines manually, we can use this respective key MPG. Then next we have SBK. SBK stands for single block. So here is the SBK on the left hand side. You can see SBK key is there, which is known as single block mode key. Now, when we write a program and we run the program, there are two ways that we can run the program. Either we can run in auto mode, or second, we can run in the single block mode. Now, what is the difference between both of them? Let me explain them to you. When we run the program in auto mode, it will start from the beginning of the line and it will stop when the end of the instruction is reached. So in between, it will not stop. But when we press the single block mode, or when we run the program in single block mode, it will stop automatically after the end of the each block. And when the one block is completed, a red light will highlight here. This at this particular point, red light will highlight, and until and unless you will not press this button again, the program will not be executed further. So after each block, the program stops itself. And when we press the single block mode again, it will execute the next line. So line by line, the program will run in single block mode. So I hope this will be clear to you now, that what is the difference between auto mode and in single block mode. Next button, we have BDT. This is the BDT button. So BDT stands for block data transfer or skip block. If you want to skip any line or any block of the program, then we can use this BDT button. Now, next we have further MDI, which is known as manual data input. So MDI is on the display screen. You can see MDI. So now how we can assess this MDI function key? You can see just below the MDI, there is a F3 key. So when we press this F3 key, we will enter into the MDI mode. So in MDI, we can write the program manually, or we can start the button, or we can, by pressing the start button, we can run the respective function. Now, there are different types of function keys which are available here, like F1 to F6. All these keys are known as function keys. Function keys. And if we press all these buttons, we will assess the respective functions like POS, path, MDI, AID, macro, teach. So when we press the respective buttons, we will enter into the respective functions. And after that, there are a number of keys are also available here. Let me explain them to you. This button stands for spindle rotation. Spindle rotation, and the symbol is in the clockwise direction. So this is the spindle rotation in clockwise. This is a spindle rotation in the counterclockwise direction. And this button is for coolant on and coolant off. When we press this button, coolant will be on. And when we again press this button, coolant will be off. And there are other keys also, like pause. We can pause our program. Start button is for when we write the program and we want to run the program, we will have to press this key, which will start the program. And after that, we have a number of keys are available here also. Like this is the arrows key, up, down. This is the left arrow, right arrow. So there are some symbols which are placed over here. So this is the spindle rotation. Suppose the program is going on and we want to increase the speed of the spindle. So when we press this key, it will increase the speed of the spindle automatically. There is no need to stop the program in between. We can directly press this key and we can increase the speed of the spindle. So spindle speed increases. When we press this button, and there is another button on the another side, if you want to decrease the speed, you can press this key. So it will decrease the spindle speed. Now on down arrow and up arrow, there are plus percentage and minus percentage is written. So which means if we want to decrease or increase the feed rate, we can use these keys. So this is for feed increase. This is for feed decrease. And there are also another buttons over here like file. So file, just like we have different types of drives in our normal computer like C drive, D drive. In our MCU, you will find similar kind of drives are there. And in between them, you will create any folders. And in between those folders, you can save your CNC programs. And if you want to access any of the program, then you can press this file and you can enter into the respective folders and access the program that you want to access. So next button, we have reset button. So reset button is just like the save button. When we write the program and we want to save it, we will press the reset button. It will save the program. Till now, we have written the program. Home is the home key. When we press this button and after homing, we will press the start button. The cutting tool will go its home position, or we can say at its machine coordinates zero. After that, we have edit button. Edit button is very, very important. Suppose we want to change our existing program. So we have opened the program after going into the file and then opening the respective program. Now we want to change the program or we want to edit the program. So until and unless we do not press the edit key, we can't change anything in that. So edit key must be pressed when we want to edit anything in the existing program. There is a jog button. Jog stands for if you want to move the axis of the machines, then we can use this jog mode, which I will explain to you further more in detail. Now auto is the mode when we run the program in auto mode. Respective keys. There are also monitor key program. In program, we will enter into the respective program system and then coordinates. We can change the coordinates of our cutting tool and then diagnose. Suppose we are facing any problem in our CNC machine, then we can enter into this diagnose and we can correct the problem or we can do the corrective measures. So these are the some of the keys which were here and we have covered all the keys. I hope it will be very much clear to you now. Now next we have for moving the axis of CNC machine tool. This is very, very important. In order to move the axis of the CNC machine tool, we have two ways. Either we can move the axis with the help of the, as we know, by manually generating the pulses, which I have explained to you earlier. So first approach is MPG. So by MPG mode, we can generate the pulses manually. In MPG mode, we will move the axis with the help of the hand wheel. So in our CNC control panel, you will find such type of wheel. And when we rotate this wheel in the clockwise direction, the respective axis will move in the positive direction. And if we rotate this hand wheel in the counterclockwise direction, the respective axis will move in the negative direction. So in the next lecture, we will cover axis in CNC machine and how to take the directions in positive and negative in different cases when we will take the positive sign and when we will take the negative sign. That we will cover in the next lecture. So after that, you will find such type of button in the control panel of MCU where X, Y, and Z, it might be written over there. So right now you can see this button is on the X side. So it means now X axis will move it at this particular time. And if we rotate this button on Y side and we rotate the hand wheel, then the Y axis will move at that particular time. Similarly for Z also, if we keep this button on the Z side, Z axis will move. Now the second way in order to move the axis of the CNC machine is the jog mode, which is here. So in jog mode, there are keys which are available here in our keyboard, the number keys. And on number keys, at, you can see at 7, there is a Z plus direction is written. At 3, there is a Z negative is written. So means when we use this jog mode, we will move the axis of the CNC machine with the help of the buttons that are available on the keyboard. So in jog mode, we will move the axis by keyboard buttons. So when we press the jog mode, kindly ensure the jog will be displayed here. And when the jog will be displayed here, and if we press any of the buttons that are available here, like Y positive, Y negative, X negative, X positive, and Z positive or Z negative. And when we press all these buttons, the respective axis will move in jog mode. So there are two ways in order to move the axis of the CNC machine tool. First is the MPG mode, that we can rotate the hand wheel and when we can rotate the respective axis. Second is the jog mode. So the keys that are available here on the keyboard, by pressing those keys, we can move the axis. And after that, there you will find some of the buttons there, like in order to on and off the machine. There you will find the right button will be for off. And there is another button, which is grid button for on. And after that, you will find a button, which is an emergency button. And if the program is not behaving the way you have intended or you have inserted the program, so the machine tool is not behaving like the way we want to move it, then in emergency case, you can press this emergency button by pressing, and it will stop the machine or the program at that particular moment. And further corrective actions can be taken further. So this is our emergency button. And this is our USB port, which is given here in MCU. And once the CNC program is written in any type of input medium, we can keep that program in pen drive and we can insert here in USB port. Now, as we know that there are two approaches or two methods to insert the program in MCU. The first approach is that we can use our keyboard buttons, that is alphanumeric characters, which are here. We can use these keys to write the program. And second is that we can write the program in any type of input medium and we can insert that program here in USB port. So this is all for our first lecture in this particular CNC course. And I hope this lecture will be clear to you. And if you find any difficulty, then you can comment on the comment box of this video, or you can also email me on my email ID, which is shown here. So thank you so much for this today's lecture. And now let us meet on our second lecture. Thank you so much.